Hi student, today in this video I am going to discuss about the electrolysis process of water. So, electrolysis process of water. So take a container. And put some water here. But if we take pure water, then we can't electrolysis because pure water cannot conduct electricity, and that is why with water we have to add some salt. So water plus a small amount of salt just to make sure that the current can pass through this water. This salt amount should be less. Now we will take two electrodes. Okay, two electrodes. One of the electrode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and the other is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. So the electrode which is connected to the positive terminal is called anode, and the electrode which is connected to the negative terminal of the battery is called cathode. Okay, now our chemical formula for water is H2O. That means water consists of hydrogen gas plus oxygen gas. Yes? So now, when current passes through this water, that means through this electrolyte, that means the solution which is used in electrolysis process is called electrolyte. So here the electrolyte is solution of water and salt. Now when current passed through this electrolyte or water, this water will break down into its constituent particle, that means hydrogen and oxygen. So first it will create hydrogen ion which is positively charged and oxygen ion which is negatively charged. So this is hydrogen ion which is positively charged, and this is oxygen ion which is negatively charged. Now this H plus or hydrogen ion, since it is positively charged, so this H plus ion will move to cathode because cathode is connected to the negative of the battery. So positive is always attracted to negative, and oxygen ion which is negatively charged, it will move to anode because anode is connected to positive terminal of the battery. Now at anode, this oxygen ion will lose electron, that means minus electron. Electron is represented by E. Will lose electron and will form oxygen gas. Okay, and at cathode this hydrogen ion will gain electron, that means plus E. It will gain electron and form hydrogen gas. Now this oxygen and hydrogen gas will come out from this solution, and that is why we can see some bubbles during the electrolysis process. Okay, now why the oxygen lose electron and hydrogen gain electron? Because oxygen ion is negative ion. It's negative means it has excess electron. Negative ion always contain excess of electron. That is why at the anode, oxygen ion release its excess electron and form oxygen gas. At cathode, since hydrogen is positively charged ion, so positively charged ion always have deficiency of electron, and that is why oxygen gain hydrogen gas gain electron and form hydrogen gas.